friends, how are you? I hope you are very well and safe with your family. Once again, welcome to my YouTube channel, Ravi Sarji Maths. Students, today we will learn about Euclid division lemma. First of all, I will tell you some brief introductions about Euclid division lemma. Students, you know that Euclid was a Greek mathematician who initiated new way of thinking, the study of geometry, because he has given a very important contribution in the field of geometry. But very few people are aware that, or very few people are know that he has given the main contribution in number system or number theory. Students, here we will talk about Euclid division lemma. So in these things, you know that students, Euclid has a book 13 elements. Elements, one of the most topic is Euclid lemma. Students, earlier you have studied that what is lemma. Lemma is a proven statement which is used to prove another statement. So this lemma was perhaps known for a long time, and still these times we are using this lemma. But first it was recorded in book number 7 of Euclid element. Euclid division algorithm is based on this lemma. This lemma is nothing but the restatement of long division process by one positive number to another positive number. Okay students, here we will use Euclid division lemma with example so that your doubts will be clear what I have told earlier. Students, I think you have studied all these things on your primary level. Let us see with example. Suppose two integers A and B. Students, you can see that two integers A and B, if A is greater than B and A is divided by B, so these numbers can be written in fractional number. Let us see with example. Suppose 25 divided by 3. So students, by log division method, we can write over here 25 divided by 3. So you can see that 3 goes how many times in 25? You know that 3 8s are 24. Means 3 goes 8 times in 25. So here students, you can write these things. 25 by 3 can be written as 8 1 by 3. Here students, you can see that 25 is dividend. 25 is dividend. 3 is divisor and 8 is quotient and 1 is remainder. So students, here you are clear that 25 divided by 3 can be written as 8 1 by 3, where 25 is dividend, 3 is divisor, 8 is quotient and 1 is remainder. So students, you can see that A number can be written as A is equal to BQ plus R, where R will be less than equal to B but greater than or equal to 0. Okay students, let us see few questions regarding this. Take the first pair of integers 27 and 2. Here students, you can see that A is 27 and B is 2. Maybe you are sometimes you having some confusions which integers we will have to take as A and which integers we will have to consider over B. So students, I make you clear that the bigger integers should be considered as A and smaller integers should be considered as B. So you can write over here A is greater than B. Okay students, so we can write 27 and 2, the pair of these integer, in the form of Euclid division lemma. So see over here 27, B is what students? Divisor 2. You can see that 2 goes how many times in 27? It might be goes 13 times, because 13 to the 26 and it gives remainder 1. Similarly students, you can see that another example. Suppose 45 and 8. If you are not getting these things, you should go through the long division process. So students, you know very well the long division process. Divides 45. So if you know the table, just read it and see how many times 8 goes in 45. So you know that 8 fives are 40. Here we are getting remainder as a 5. So students, 45 and 8, these pairs of integer can be represented using Euclid division lemma. So A, according to A, BQ plus R, what is A over here? 45. B is what? 8. Quotient is what? 5. And remainder is what? 5. Let us see the next question. Suppose you having number 112. So you can see that 100 is to be divided by 12 and that long division process can be written in the form of Euclid division lemma. So again we are doing the same process over here. You will have to read the table of 12. So you can read the table of 12. 12 8s are. 100 minus 96, 4. So, students, here you can see that A. What is A? 100. What is B? 12. What is Q? 8. What is R? 4. So, here we can write 100 is equal to 12 into 8. Plus 4. Okay, students, I'm giving you a few questions for the practice. Just note it down in your notebook and keep practice to make yourself confident and remove your fear from mathematics. Thank you. Thank you so much. I hope you have understood these topics. So, make yourself confident by practicing all these questions. I'm going to put up a few questions regarding this Euclid division lemma. I hope you have understood this video's lecture. For keep watching this video again and again. If you having any doubts, just put the comment box any questions, any doubt and any topics. So, I will make clear your all the doubts and all the topics.